With the closure of more and more factories and offices, many thousands of people who thought their jobs would always be safe are finding themselves looking for new ones. But there are some companies in central London who are doing better than most in the recession. They're the ones brought in by struggling firms to handle their layoffs and offer counselling to the workforce.
You get all sorts of reactions. Our business is a very cheerful business because people do get jobs in the end. They're not dead. The actions range from absolute anger to someone coming and saying, well, that's a relief, it's happened at last, and I've got a package, I want to get on with it, but don't tell them I'm happy about it.
Michael O'Connor is one senior executive who's being counselled.
I've been resident in the UK since 1973. Mm-hmm. I've been with a large US international corporation for 27 years. Yeah.
In that time, he rose to the position of vice president, but now faces redundancy. Until the right job comes along, he's preparing to ride out the recession.
So we have plans for some immediate work starting in the 1st of December, which will be a bit of a change for me driving transit vans in Kent.
He's one of an army of people looking for the right job for his skills, and their ranks will swell in the next 3 years, following the announcement by the insurance group Eagle Star that they're shedding 1,000 jobs.
We provide support for them, and redundancy of the person as opposed to the job is always the last option. Where that is unavoidable, we have financial provision to assist.
But no matter how much help staff are given in their search for new jobs, until an upturn fills the vacancy boards, they'll still face a long wait. Rob McBride for Thames News.